Not all heroes wear capes. In fact, some wear red sweaters. I am indeed talking about Kenneth Bone, who was a town hall audience member who asked Donald Trump and Hillary Clinton about energy policy. And for whatever reason, the Twitterverse just exploded with love and admiration for Kenneth Bone. He sat down with CNN, and let's take a look at one of this clip.
I went from last night having 7 Twitter followers, 2 of which were my grandmother because she had to remake her account when she forgot her password, to now I have several hundred. I don't know why they care what I have to say, but I'm glad they're engaged in the political process.
Well, I think they thought you were quite charming. In fact, you told my booker, Nyjah, why you chose to wear that red sweater. Can you share with us?
Yeah, I had a really nice olive suit that I love a great deal, and my mother would have been very proud to see me wearing on television. But apparently I've gained about 30 pounds, and when I went to get in my car the morning of the debate, I split the seat of my pants all the way open. So the red sweater is plan B. I'm glad it worked out.
No, this is America. This guy, his new name is Mr. America. I love this guy.
I love him so much.
Okay. He went with the red sweater because the olive suit was like got busted open. The olive suit, I can't wait to see the olive suit. They got to repair it and have him come back on in the next town hall.
Needs to make a comeback.
Okay. And who says on national TV, I mean, I was gained too much weight. So I sat down and I split the thing, you know what I'm saying?
Well, let's take a look at some of the memes that have been created about Kenneth Bone. He's quite the legend, so let's take a look at some of these.
What? Yes, that's so right.
The Bone Collector in Toy Story 2, accurate. What else do we have?
Except he's not evil, he's all good.
Oh, this is so great. Good. I love this one from Office Space.
That's funny, I was going to say that in the morning.
Have you seen my stapler?
Yes.
Don't
take my stapler.
What else do we have? Yes, Halloween, get ready, it's coming up. I'm very much thinking anyone can go as Ken Bone. Honestly, it's very simple.
Yeah, throw yourself a bone.
Throw yourself Bone Thugs and Harmony.
Love it.
Yes.
So fantastic.
By the way, he wants Harmony. One of the reasons that he's an undecided voter and he's slightly pissed at Donald Trump for bringing disharmony. Mm-hmm. So he is. He's Bone Thugs and Harmony.
Bone Thugs and Harmony. And then I love this one. A love story. Him.
Yeah. Instead of her with Scarlett Johansson.
Ken Bone.
It's sweet. He just has like this general charm and positive energy to him. Just an easygoing, lovable guy.
He's just good vibes only.
Unassuming. And he had
as we were doing the live coverage last night, and he came on, we instantly exploded. Right?
Oh, so
we're like, playing by playing. We're like, this guy's awesome. This guy's awesome. And I started calling him Mr. Christmas. Because it's in October, and he's got the most obvious Christmas sweater of all time on. And he's like, and he just wanted to know about energy policy.
Yeah, so I was going to ask, why do you guys think he captivated the nation so much? Why do you think it was his question? Do you think it was how he looked, how he was dressed, or just his general sort of mannerisms? He seems very optimistic, a very hopeful guy. What do you think it is?
First of all, the sweater, boom, home run. We already love him.
Absolutely.
Instant reaction, right? It's an instant classic. Mm-hmm.
Okay. The Ken Bone.
So then, afterwards, a tweet went around of him at a nearly empty town hall taking pictures.
Oh,
like,
yeah, I think we have that video.
Let's watch
that video. There he is with his disposable camera taking photos.
It's not a smartphone.
Great.
It's unbelievable.
He's winding it up. He's winding it up and taking photos. I just love him so much.
And when I think about the undecided voter in America, I want it to be Ken Bone. Mm-hmm. Because there's other people who, maybe for whatever reason are pretending to be undecided, or, you just want to put a face to that idea of the person that the candidates are still trying to reach out to. And I hope that it is Ken Bone, just someone, a smiley, happy guy looking for answers.
The two comments you guys made connect, right? So what is it about Ken Bone? It's an obvious innocence that he's got. Like, who doesn't come out of the house like I might be on TV today. Should I go with the Christmas sweater?
Love him.
Let's go with the Christmas sweater, right? There's an innocence in there that you could tell immediately, right? And then that's why you want him to be the undecided voter. Because Ken's a good guy. Everybody knows he's a good guy, right? Maybe he doesn't know, he's still undecided. Hillary Clinton or Donald Trump, their positions are fairly clear. Ken still hasn't made up his mind. He's trying to figure out what to wear. But, you trust him. He's a good guy. And so he's the kind of guy to go on CNN and go, tell you about how his grandmother has two Twitter accounts and she's two out of his seven followers.
And how he's just stoked that people are engaging in the political process. That's what you want the undecided voter to be, someone whose vote they're really sort of mulling it over and really thinking about the issues and just enjoying the, you know, the election process. But that, I understand that. I do agree. I think that that's who you want the undecided voter to be.
Then again, we talk about this guy who's like, I guess I'll just wear the red sweater. Is this the same guy who's probably like, oh, wait, there are people running for president. I should get on that.
Whoa.
Whereas everyone else has just been racking their mind and picking up the phone and checking every latest new breaking story.
But think about
There's Ken Bones out there who are like, I'm sorry, I was mowing my lawn today.
Okay, his question on energy policy was not an obvious question.
That's
I think
true.
That is also part of why...
And they almost never ask it.
They that's almost right. never ask it. I think that that's another reason why people really liked Kenneth Bone. I think we should refer to him with his full name, Kenneth Bone.
Or K-Bone.
K-Bone!
Or K-Bone.
He's so K-Bone!
K-Bone.
K-Bone.
With respect,
but I think
which
that
is also
with
respect.
That's why people liked him, because he asked a difficult, not a difficult question, but a question we don't hear about a lot that does matter to a lot of people. And he had this, again, this sort of earnest nature to how he asked the question, and it's an important question.
They cut out the part where he's like, and I'm sorry, what are your names again? You are Donnie?
No, but that's the thing, Brett. He has an innocence without being stupid.
Yeah.
Like,
yeah,
you never
yeah.
get a sense that Ken's, like, not bright. He's probably an accountant and he's probably good at that, mm-hmm. right? You know what I'm saying? But at the same time, he's the guy earnest enough to go on national TV and go, I wanted to make my mom proud and I thought the olive soup would do it, right? And I wasn't sure what their energy policy was. And at the end, they said, which way are you leaning? And he's like, man, I was really undecided. I guess I'm still undecided. But I didn't like the way that Donald Trump was kind of mean to Hillary Clinton, mm-hmm. and I thought she stood up for herself a little bit there. I guess I'm leaning in her direction.
Yeah, he said he liked how she withstood the attacks from Donald Trump.
Yeah, and I think that the bottom line is, yes, K-Bone might decide the election by on election day going, do I go with the red or the olive sweater today? Okay, red? Okay, Trump, right? Like, that might happen, right? Or... Yeah. He looks at it right before the election, as he's doing now, and he does the right thing.
Yeah, he's a counterpoint. He's a counterpoint to what people dread about this election. All the approach to it is like this is the most like knockdown, all out brawl of an election, and then you just see like sunrise.
Yeah,
Ken's out here. Did you want some cookies?
Yeah, pure goodness in the middle of a deeply evil campaign, right? Mm-hmm. And that's why it's so refreshing. He was mourning in America.
Yeah.
He was Bone in the USA.
Oh, God.
Young Turks membership is awesome.
Says who?
Says me. But.
Please believe me.
TYTnetwork.com/join.